I'm a Windows guy that has always built his own PC desktops, but now this tiny $600 M4 Mac Mini is making me question everything I know about budget video editing. In this video, I'm going to review this Mac Mini and tell you whether you should consider using it for 4K video editing, especially if you are on a budget. Also, this video is sponsored by my friends at Ulanza, and I will tell you more about them later in the video. Now, as I said, I bought this Mac Mini with my own money. Apple didn't send it to me or anything like that. And I have to say, after buying a MacBook Air and being really impressed by it in early 2025, I really wanted to see how a M4 Mac Mini with similar specs but an actual fan would perform as well. And little teaser for you, the results are surprising. So let's start by talking specs. I want you to know that I have a buyer's guide that I put together that details the best bang for your buck Mac Mini that you can buy today, which I will link to up in the corner and down in the video description. And spoiler, in my opinion, the best bang for your buck Mac Mini is going to be the base Mac Mini that you can oftentimes find yourself buying online for $600 or even $500. That's such a killer deal for a tiny computer like this. But in my case, I wanted a bit more than the best bang for your buck because I had a bit more money to spend and I had a specific need. But don't worry, I still kept things under $1,000. And for the sake of comparison, this Mac Mini still has the same exact chip and RAM as the $600 option, so it will operate at the same speed. The only difference is I chose to spend an extra $200 on storage, bringing up the internal SSD from 256 gigabytes to 512. And I also spent an extra $100 to upgrade to a 10 gigabit Ethernet port because I have a NAS that I wanted to use with it. Side note, if you are concerned about this computer only having 512 gigabytes of storage, I have an accessory that I'm going to be talking about soon that will negate those storage worries. Just wait. Next, let's talk about the size of this thing. To be clear, the Mac Mini line has always been small, but the M4 Mac Mini is downright tiny. I'm a guy that is used to having a huge mid ATX size tower case on my desktop. Heck, the first desktop I built was a full-sized tower case and weighed like 80 pounds, and I would transport that thing back and forth from my apartment in college in the trunk of my car. It was insane. It's like transporting a body, though. What's crazier, though, is that this Mac Mini can not only easily fit in your hand, but it can also offer better video editing performance than a large desktop. I told you, it's crazy. Don't worry, we will get to talking about performance soon. Back to the Mac Mini size now, though, because there is one drawback I've found to it being this size, and that is the amount of ports on the Mac Mini, or really the lack thereof. With a PC desktop, you're usually getting a lot of ports. I'm a guy that loves ports. My desktop has something like, here we go, rotate around here, 8 USB-A ports and USB-C and multiple display ports. Get it in focus here. I gotta hold up on the site. It's gonna fall. Oh no, there we go. Saved it. It's a lot of inputs here, okay? That's what I'm saying here. I like a lot of ports. I use a ton of external drives. For a while, I was running 3 monitors. I clearly love connecting things to my desktops. There's more ports on the front of this thing too. But then we get to the Mac Mini, which has noticeably less ports. 2 USB-C ports on the front, 3 Thunderbolt ports on the back, all with USB Type-C connections, and 1 measly HDMI port. That's it. Okay, I know this computer is supposed to be the tiny option, and if I upgraded to a Mac Studio, I would get 5 Thunderbolt ports plus 2 USB-A, but still, there has to be a better way, some way to expand the ports on this Mac Mini and make it more like the PC desktop port situation that I know and love. And that's where the sponsor of this video, Ulanza, comes in, because they have a wide range of Mac Mini capability extending products that they have sent over for me to use with this M4 Mac Mini. Up first, let's tackle that pesky lack of ports issue, and that is easily handled by the Ulanza QT03 docking station that has a similar design to the Mac Mini, so it will look good on your desk while also dramatically expanding its capabilities. This dock plugs into one of the USB-C ports on your Mac Mini and adds 3 more USB ports, 1 USB-C, 2 USB-A, and a second HDMI output, headphone jack, and my favorite favorite for video editing, dual memory card readers, one SD and one micro SD. Are you wondering why this docking station has this shape? That's because inside it is a hidden feature. It doubles as an NVMe SSD enclosure that connects with 40 gigabytes per second speeds, meaning you can purchase up to an 8 terabyte NVMe SSD, install it inside it, and expand the storage of your Mac Mini for a dramatically cheaper price than you would if you had to purchase the storage directly from Apple. Then, if you want to elevate your Mac Mini, literally, and help guarantee it has the best airflow while also being a statement piece on your desk, Ulanza also makes this super cute QT01 Mac Mini case that essentially transforms it into a mini Mac Pro that you can mount vertically or horizontally. You can even stack the QT03 docking station with this vertical Mac Mini case into the ultimate Mac Mini. So I would highly recommend checking out all this Ulanza gear for your Mac Mini in the description down below. Back to talking about accessories now. You should know that the Mac Mini is a bit bare bones, let's say out of the box. Unlike the much more expensive iMac, for example, the Mac Mini doesn't come with a keyboard or mouse or screen. Nope, you have to buy those separately. But that said, I thankfully already have and love a Logitech MX Keys S keyboard and a MX Master 3S mouse, not a sponsor. And look how used this thing is, by the way. It's definitely had a lot of age. This is not dirt on it. This is like the plastic is peeling because I've used this thing so much over the years. But hey, reliable product, haven't needed to upgrade yet. Might need to eventually though. Logitech, get at me here. Moving on now, let's talk about power. There's no battery life to worry about with the Mac Mini because it is not a portable computer in that sense. But I was happy to discover that just like my MacBook Air, the Mac Mini will instantly turn on and go to sleep, which is quite a workflow change after living with my home-built PCs for over a decade. With my PC desktops, I would always shut them off at night and then power them back on the next morning because otherwise they would be wasting power, generating heat, running the fans all night, which would eventually break and was entirely unnecessary. In short, I felt bad about leaving my PC on. And because sleep and hibernation were always a bit finicky on Windows, especially with custom-built systems leading to blue screens or the computer becoming unresponsive, in short, a full shutdown was always my usual and best option. Then, when it came to time to turn the desktop back on, I was always looking at waiting anywhere from 30 seconds to a minute or two, depending on how Windows was feeling that day to turn on. Enter the Mac Mini though, and suddenly I can put it to sleep without worrying about it. It sips power, it goes to sleep and wakes up without issue, and has virtually instant startup time because I rarely have to fully shut it down. It's truly a great experience. Regardless, we gotta talk about my experience video editing with the Mac Mini. Yes, it's finally time to talk performance and speed with this computer. If you remember from my M4 MacBook Air review, that laptop essentially blew my mind when it came to video editing because I opened up DaVinci Resolve, started a project, and was absolutely floored by how quickly the laptop could cut through 4K and even 6K video footage. So let me just say, I thought I knew what to expect when I used the Mac Mini. I assumed that because this computer has the same chip as the MacBook Air, but it now includes a fan, that it would help mitigate any throttling that the MacBook Air experienced and would be much faster as a result, especially whenever it came time to do things like export a video. But here I was being surprised again, because the performance gap for video editing is actually really minimal between these two computers. Just like on the MacBook Air, things would load quickly and the timeline would scrub like butter, and even when I had to apply multiple effects, the Mac Mini handles it easily, just like the MacBook Air did. In short, from a timeline perspective, I struggle thinking of who would need to buy the M4 Pro version of the Mac Mini, much less a Mac Studio or other high-end desktop with a Max or Ultra chip, because this base level M4 chip Mac Mini with only 16 gigs of memory handles 4K and 6K video editing so well. Let's talk more about that fan in the Mac Mini though. Remember, the MacBook Air didn't have one, so it was 100% silent, which was already jarring to me coming from Dell and Asus laptops that sounded like jet engines taking off. And don't even talk about my desktop here, okay? Because on the PC front, my custom-built PCs have unsurprisingly always had fans, and a lot of them. Heck, my desktop here has six 6 fans, and while they're labeled as quote-unquote quiet fans, they're still plenty loud, creating a rather ignorable but always present white noise effect in my room while editing. But here we are with the Mac Mini, and unlike my PC with its mini fans, it just has one. And I gotta say, I consistently find myself struggling to know if the fan inside is even spinning. To be clear, the fan does spin, but it's very minimal, at 1,000 RPM most of the time. And yes, that applies even when rendering a video. You can put your ear right up next to it, which I've done many times, and you don't hear a thing. And speaking of rendering, we need to talk about the export speed with this Mac Mini, because this is also where the Mac Mini surprised me compared to the MacBook Air. Remember, both of these devices have the same processor and memory, but the fan is where they differ, because while the MacBook Air is very fast on the timeline due to only needing performance in short bursts, it will slow down when rendering a video due to the processor generating heat and not having a fan to diffuse it. Or at least, that's what I thought, because whenever I tested the Mac Mini and the MacBook Air head-to-head, exporting a video in DaVinci Resolve, they were essentially identical, both taking 4 minutes and approximately 8 seconds to export a 10-minute long video with a mix of 4K and 6K video clips. But then, when I tested Premiere Pro, this is where I saw a small difference, with the MacBook Air taking 11 minutes and 50 seconds, while the Mac Mini took 11 minutes and 9 seconds. Was it the fan? Well, whenever I downloaded an app to check the fan speed, even when rendering this video, it stayed at a very slow baseline of 1,000 RPMs, which is fairly slow in the world of computers, and that also means that the computer didn't get hot enough when rendering to need to run the fan faster. So yes, the fan helped a little bit, but whenever I used a fan app to ramp up the fan speeds and attempt to help the computer render faster, even with the faster fans on the Mac Mini, it still rendered the video in Premiere Pro in 11 minutes and 9 seconds, just like it did when the fans weren't spinning at all. So in short, if you are expecting the base M4 Mac Mini to be a huge jump over the M4 MacBook Air, there really isn't a huge difference in the world of video editing. And if you are okay with a desktop versus a laptop, the Mac Mini is basically half the cost of the MacBook Air, as long as you have a screen, keyboard, and mouse to use with it. I have to say, from a video editing perspective, as a Windows guy that has built his own PCs for his whole life and loves doing it, I love tinkering with them, I love putting it together, it's so fun, but this Mac Mini is, in my opinion, the best cheap computer that you can buy today for video editing, and the options from the Windows PC side aren't even close when it comes to this price. You will not be able to get the speed that you get from Windows at this cost. It is crazy. For so long, Windows was really the best option for budget video editing. You could build your own PC for less than $1,000 and have it run rings around a Mac that you would have to spend $1,000 to $2,000 for. But it's not like that any longer. And I'm sure you're probably wondering then, am I going to switch fully over to Mac? I have a MacBook Air, now I have a Mac Mini. Should I sell my PC desktop? Migrate fully over? Nah, I like PC gaming too much for that. And my desktop is still extremely quick, and I like using both, depending on my mood and the project I'm working on. Just like how I use both DaVinci Resolve and Premiere Pro interchangeably as a video editor, I'm going to be using both of these interchangeably to edit my videos. I'll link down in the video description to my Mac Mini buyer's guide, as well as the Mac Mini that I recommend that you purchase. In addition, if you want to buy a MacBook, I'll link to a company called Upgraded, which lets you purchase MacBooks with an upgrade program, just like an iPhone, where you can get a new MacBook every 2 years for a low monthly cost. It's super cool and doesn't cost any more than if you bought the laptop outright with AppleCare, which is great. And while you're down there, I'll also link to my Edit Videos Like a Pro guide. This is a free guide that I've put together that's gonna show you some of the biggest pro editing tips that I've learned over the years editing. Like I said, it's completely free and will blow your mind, and it's linked in the video description. Thanks so much for watching. Please like this video and subscribe if you want to see more videos about video editing and Apple Macs, etc. in the future. And let me know what other videos you want to see me make about this computer. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.